Hey guys, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So welcome to our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our mains answer writing series. So friends, we have a series in which what we do, we daily give you a certain number of questions of which you have to write the answers. So the students were demanding that sir, please also start uploading the model answers of these questions that you provide daily. So depending upon that request, we decided to discuss one model answer with you people every day, so that you people can get an idea that how to approach a particular question that is asked to you. So today also we will be discussing one question, and it is about your article 370 and article 35A. So what is the question? So here you have to critically analyze the validity of contentious article 370 and article 35A recently seen in news. So the word limit is 250 and the maximum marks are 15. So let's start the answer. But before starting answer, let me tell you friends that no answer can be a model answer. It is just a term that is wrongly used by the students. That's why the students use this term, that's why we used it. Otherwise no answer in UPSC can be model answer, because as every answer has its own positives and negatives, and had that been the case, that is our question would have been model answer, then the students would have scored 100% marks in UPSC. But you can see the topper scores between 50 to 55%, so that means that no answer in UPSC can be model answer. So let's start a discussion about the article 370 and article 35A. So friends, before starting, let me tell you that do give a proper attention to the directive in the question. So here you have been asked to critically analyze. So what does it mean? Critically analyze means you have to look at the article 370 and article 35A from both the perspectives, that is its positives and its negatives. So you can start by telling what is article 370 and article 35A. So article 370 is basically part of part 21 of the constitution, and part 21 is basically temporary, transitional and special provisions. So this part is entitled this by this name, that is temporary, transitional and special provisions. And what is article 370? It is basically an article that gives special status to Jammu and Kashmir and restricts Indian parliament to make any laws for the J&K state. So except the subjects like defense, external affairs and communication. So in short, in very simple terms, we can say that the Union government has control over Jammu and Kashmir only on three subjects, that is defense, external affairs and communication. With regard to other subjects, the only the state government can the state legislature can decide upon, and depending upon the state legislature decision, the parliament has to proceed, or the Union government has to proceed. So it means that laws related to union and concurrent list in J&K, they can be passed only after consultation with the state government. So it means that a law that is passed by Parliament of India, it does not automatically applies to Jammu and Kashmir unless and until the legislature of this particular state authorizes to do so, that is to extend the law passed by the Parliament of India to the state. So important provisions under the article are, let's see what are the important provisions. So basically important provisions in it are defined by one more article, that is article 35A. So what does these two articles lead to? The combined impact of these two provisions is that the state residents live under a separate set of laws. So for example, including citizenship, ownership of property, fundamental rights as compared to other Indians, that is the rights, the laws which are applicable to other Indian citizens are not applicable to the state residents of Jammu and Kashmir. And also one more thing about this is this provision is that under article 35A, the state legislature has the power to define who is permanent resident of Jammu and Kashmir, and depending upon that criteria, the state can give that person special privileges and rights with respect to jobs in we can say government and also with relation in relation to buying of say selling or purchasing a property. So here in under this provision, Indian citizens are not allowed to purchase land or property in Jammu and Kashmir. So under Article 370, the center has no power also to declare the financial emergency, that is under Article 360 of the Constitution. So it can declare emergency only in case of war or external aggression. That is, Union government cannot therefore declare emergency on the grounds of internal disturbance, that is, or you can also say on the grounds of armed insurgency. Or imminent danger, unless it is made at the request or with concurrence of state government. And also Indian parliament cannot reduce or increase the border of the state. And also jurisdiction of parliament of India in relation to Jammu and Kashmir is confined to matters enumerated in the union list and also the concurrent list. And there is no state list for state of Jammu and Kashmir. And basically the residuary powers also are with this the legislature of the JNK assembly if in case we consider other states, then the residuary powers rest with union government, but in the case of Jammu and Kashmir, these residuary powers belong to legislature of the state. So the power to make laws relating to preventive detention extra, they belong to the legislature of JNK. So that power is not available to Indian parliament, and also no preventive detention law thereby cannot automatically extend to Jammu and Kashmir unless and until the assembly of the state can authorize this to do so. So part 4 also, that is directive principles of state policy, and part 4a fundamental duties are also not applicable to JNK, and also name and boundary of the state cannot be changed, and also penal code is different, and also the state has a separate flag of its own. So for example, in India there is an Indian penal code, but in Jammu and Kashmir there is Ranbir penal code. So duration is also 6 years of the legislative assembly, unlike the 5 in the rest of India. So president may by notification declare that this Article 370 or Article 35A shall cease to be operative, but only on the recommendations of the Constituent Assembly of the state. So due to this, this state enjoys special privileges, and also it basically the purpose of Article 370 when it was included was to kind of provide a space in matters of governance to the people of state. Because the kind of accession that the Jammu and Kashmir had happened, that was a particular case, and at that time it was necessary to assure the state government and its citizens to that union government will not cause any harm to the Muslim majority state of Jammu and Kashmir. So Article 370 was basically providing space in matters of governance and also to address the vulnerabilities which the people felt about their identity and insecurity they felt about their future. So it was about empowering people, and also about ensuring accountability of public institutions and services, and also it is synonymous with decentralization and devolution of power in Indian federalism. So a few months back, a PIL was filed in Supreme Court, and under which it was contended that this Article 370 and Article 35A, they are discriminatory against non-residents as far as government jobs and real estate properties, real estate purchases are concerned. So this was challenged that Article 370 and Article 35A being discriminatory against the non-residents of the state, being discriminatory against the Indian citizens, it must be repealed, because leading to integration of India properly. So there are various aspects of debate. Now let's see what are the various aspects of debate about this article. So there are multiple debates. For example, then there is a very nature about there is a debate about the very nature of Article 370. So some people say that as the heading of the part 21 suggests, that this part contain provisions that are temporary, transitional and special. financial. Then if under Article 370 is also under this part, and when it is clearly mentioned that these are the temporary provisions, then why it is still continuing even after the nearly 70 years of independence? So this article also another aspect of debate is of procedure. So often those who oppose this article, it is alleged that this article 370 was not inserted into constitution by parliament by way of amendment under the article 368, but rather it was inserted by the president order. So certainly a constitution cannot be amended by the president order. So this article in itself, the procedure of this article is in violation of the constitution, because it hadn't followed the procedure laid down under Article 368. And also it is alleged that this leads to violation of fundamental rights of women of the state. So how it is against the fundamental rights of women of the state? Because those women who marry outside the Jammu and Kashmir state, they are deprived of the property rights that they were earlier entitled to. So it is a clear kind of disincentive, and women are denied their share of property in the state, and also other sections of society are also there who are not able to enjoy their fundamental rights, whether they are manual scavengers, and then there are West Pakistani refugees. So these people are not able to exercise their fundamental rights. So it is also criticized that the state government, by using these provisions, discriminate against the citizens of India on an unfair basis. So as I have told you that you have to critically analyze, that is you have to look at both the aspects of the of these provisions. So now we will look at that aspect, that why it should be revoked. So first thing is Article 370 and 35A. So they bar non-subjects, that is the people that are from the outside, those people who are not from Jammu and Kashmir, they cannot buy property there. So also no industry can be set up there, no manufacturing unit can be set up there, and this is the case only with Jammu and Kashmir. But no other state bars any state subject of J&K to invest there, acquire land or set business establishment. So here it is argued that it is asymmetric federalism and not cooperative federalism. So cooperative federalism is basically on the basis of reciprocation. So when Jammu and Kashmir people are eligible to hold property rights in other states, and then why not the other state people are not allowed to buy property in Jammu and Kashmir? So this is one thing. And second is about your obstacle in attracting the flow of investment, because obviously the non-state subject cannot buy property in Kashmir due to this. So this is a kind of it is argued that it is an obstacle in attracting the flow of investment from big business houses which are running mega projects giving employment, because when you are not able to buy property, you will not be able to invest there, and if you are not even investing there, then job avenues will be less, and also it will be an obstacle to attract the flow of investment. So as I've told you clearly, the lack of job avenues is there, and there are people who are educated but are unemployed, so they seek their livelihood out of the state. And it is argued that in coming 15 to 20 years, when the entire youth population of the state will look for job avenues outside the state boundary, then this will convert the state into a land of old and aged people, that is the population that is dependent upon the youth population. So this is a very serious matter, and it must be taken note of by the government. And also other aspect is that unemployment there is leading to the militancy, because ultimately obviously militancy has multiple reasons. But one reason that could be held responsible for this militancy is also the unemployment, because if you are not busy, if you are not doing something in which kept you busy, then suddenly you start moving towards things that keep you busy, but they are harmful for you. So militancy is that thing in Kashmir. And also then the Article 370 and 35A, they are a source of gender bias, it is said. So as I've told you, the women who are marrying outside the state, they are not eligible to hold the property rights. And also then there is argument that this is a temporary provision, so it has never got assent of the President of India or Parliament or the Government of India, and it is the fraud on a basic structure of our Constitution, because any amendment that is any amendment that has to be brought to the Constitution, it must be as per the procedure, and when procedure was not followed, then certainly it is a kind of, we can say, fraud on the basic structure of our Constitution. And then there is also said that this is temporary provision, and Article 370 has become a tool in the hands of the Union Government to bring amendments by using wrong means, then why not remove it, so that to bring normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir, so as to bring this state out at par with other states. And then also there is a critics also say that this is a case of appeasement and it should be deleted, because it acts as a, we can say, hindrance in the complete merger of Jammu and Kashmir with the nation. So it, which is complete merger is in the interest of larger and national integration, so but by repeal by the existence of this article, this has been not happening by the existence of Article 370 and 35A. So also then there is it is a less that there is a legal provision in India in which religious places cannot be used for political purposes. That is the religious places, they cannot be used for spreading the propaganda, political propaganda. But that this legal provision doesn't apply to Jammu and Kashmir. So when this provision doesn't apply, so it kind of compromises the secular aspect of the state, and also. So here we can say that state does not come under the ambit of secularism. Other thing is that when it is also less that when separatists give anti-India speeches from the ramparts of mosque, so the government forces, they can't do much, because because this legal provision is not applicable to Jammu and Kashmir. So had that been applicable, the government agencies could have acted against the anti-Indian elements who preach against India in the ramparts of mosque routinely after Friday prayers. So this is also less than. And other thing is also that there is corruption. So corruption is everywhere. It is not just in India, it is in Jammu Kashmir as well. So when corruption is everywhere, then why not the procedures that are applicable to other parts of India which hold the government accountable or the government agencies accountable, then why these provisions are not applicable to Jammu and Kashmir? For example, there is the office of CAG, the Constitutional Office of Controller and Auditor General, and there is Lokpal, there is CBI, and then when these mechanisms are not applicable to state, then corruption, the development process is hampered, and corruption continues rampant. So this is also the issue. And then also RTI is not applicable to the state right to information. So this is a kind of hindrance in the accountability and transparency of the government. So civil society of the state lacks this tool to fight corruption. So this is a major issue. Then also there are other things that say that it must not be repealed immediately, abruptly. So it is said that it cannot be revoked unilaterally. It is important to take the people of Jammu and Kashmir on board, and it must be necessary that we promote cooperative federalism and we build confidence in the people, especially the youth of the Kashmir, that Kashmir is an integral part of India by making them a part of the economic progress of India. And also law and order situation should also be under control, and people must be taken into we can say confidence, and also there must not be hate mongering by the social media and fake news. It needs to be curbed, and campaigns for peace should be carried out so that people of India feel more acceptance for the people of Kashmir. So this is a kind of more prudent way to integrate Kashmir with India. And then also there must be a state government, and state government must also focus on consensus democracy, because if you are a particular religion, if a particular religion is in majority in your state, that doesn't mean that you will pay just attention to the needs of that religion. There are other people also. For example, in case of Jammu region, there is Hindu population. So those the decision must be based on the basis of consensus building. So decision must be democratic, and it must also take into account a broad range of options, as opposed to systems where minority opinions can can potentially be ignored by vote winning majorities. So this is all about today's question. So you can see that this question itself has consumed 20 minutes. So it is difficult for us to discuss each and every question and its answer here. And if you like this answer, then do ensure that you like it, you share it with your friends. And lastly, if in case you are interested to join our answer writing series, you can join the link of which is provided here, and the link will also be provided in the description box. So three questions will be, as I have told you, five questions are given to you, three from your current topics and two from your static topics. And we will not just give you model answer of one question, but the reference answer of all the answers will be shared with you if you join our test series. And also we will be providing comprehensive feedback on your answers and will help you in improving your answer writing skills. And also you can join it on monthly basis and it is least costly. So if in case you are you're difficult to pay for a long we can say for a high paid test series, then you can join on monthly basis as well. So if in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you check the description box, and also lastly ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So this is all about today's video. Thank you, have a very nice day ahead.